Japanese scientist Norio Taniguchi, he first used this term, nanotechnology, back in 74. And then it grows from there. Now after 2000, widely nanotechnology is growing. Everywhere, I'll show you that. Carbon molecule, that is a, you know, that buckyball, that carbon. 60 carbon make it like a soccer ball. They make that this component. Thousand and thousand paper published by this molecule. Okay, that's a game here, nano. Carbon nanosheet is nano things. DNA even, 2 nanometer and the size, molecule is also here. So, as he was talking about that, so we are playing with nano matrices, 1 to 100 nanometer, not 100 or 300, on this one. Okay, now what is this? I'm sure that if you go to the museum, some European museum, you'll see this kind of cup. So it's growing. So that means in that time, 100 years ago, nanotechnology was there because it said nanopigmentation is there. Now people are seeing that this is a nanotechnology. But we didn't know that in that time. We knew that in that time that nanotechnology, nobody knows that. So it was exist, but 1959, the people knows all over the world that Richard Feynman, he is the father of nanotechnology or nanoscience, that there is a something in the bottle that we didn't see. Now question is, what is nanometer? That's the 1 billionth of 1 meter. Eh? That means 10 to the minus 9. 1 billionth of 1 meter. So, Bangla kya hai? যে এক মিনিট এক মিটার দশ লক্ষ বাঘের একবার, তাই না? এক মিটার, তো দিস ইজ দ্য ন্যানোমিটার. সো নাও কোশ্চেন ইজ, হাউ ক্যান উই ওয়ার্ক দ্য ন্যানো 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 থিংস? দ্যাট ইজ আনসি. ইয়েস, পিপল আর ওয়ার্কিং লট অফ থিংস. সো নেক্সট স্লাইড. সো ইট মিনস ভেরি ভেরি টাইনি 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 থিংস. সো দে আর সো মেনি থিংস আর ন্যানো, ন্যানো ক্রিস্টাল, কোয়ান্টাম ডটস, ন্যানো পার্টিকলস, ন্যানো ওয়্যার, ন্যানো টিউব. দে আর সো মেনি থিংস. You can see that. Now, let's start from gold nanoparticles. So, what is the gold color? Can you tell me, one student, what is the gold color? Now, where are the gold? Gold jewelry, what is the color? I can hear you. What is the color of gold? Yellow, isn't it? That is what I want to hear. So, yellow color, but this is the, we can see, eh? We make the jewelry. But, when you take that, once again, that metal or whatever, that precious metal is gold, gold metal or bar. If you take gold money to go all the way very small, that nanometer scale, then this is the color. It depends on size depending. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, these are all gold nanoparticles. Now color is different, why? Because it's size depending. Different size. Is it clear everybody? Now, so gold is, dark is gold color. Just want to tell you that, students, mainly. So now you are thinking about so small, bring it in the nano level, that is 1 billionth of 1 meter, and this is size, maybe one is 5 nanometer, one is 20 nanometer, but color is different color. Is it clear, everybody? That's the nanoparticle. Okay, one example I gave you, that gold one. Like, there are so many of them also. There are some quantum dots, these are different colors, growing, just the frozen properties. Some are tube, some are spherical, some are different shape. Now, wire like. Huh? So, all of you see the 1 200 nanometer. Huh? And what is the application? Semiconductor industry, because most of you know here, insulators, magnetic materials, ceramics. Huh? Is there another industry? Buckyballs, metal semiconductor. Sulfide nitrates, carbon, fullerenes. There are so many things can be application we can use for that nanometers. Next slide, please. Okay, now look at the application in. Now the world is going on with the nanometers. One is defense and security, we can use that. There are so many things they are using in instrumentation, nanometers to coat it for explosive or other things. Like terahertz spectroscopy, they are using to make the like explosive stuff. They are using nanotechnology there. Cosmetics in Spain, very, very popular. Very, very popular. In medicine, yesterday I was doing some dental treatment. So the guy is my friend. He told I'm using the nano, some kind of filling. So say, nano composite filling. So I told, okay, so what is that medicine? But the company told that this is a good for to bind, to make, hold the, filling will take. It's much better than normal one. So you say, they're using some kind of nano composite there. So you say, for example, one, and then there are so many things I'll talk about. One of the part of nanomedicine, one of the part will be starting from medicine. Then biotechnology, yesterday I was talking in January University, they have a biotechnology and genetic department itself, their separate department. So I was talking about that. There are so many things they are working on nano there. They are working on that. Nano optics, nano energy or storage. This is I'll cover. This is I'll cover. Now agriculture, nano pesticides, nano fertilizer. They're using the, those who are in the agriculture industry. Textile, I have a one project I was talking with you, some professors here, about that, in to improve the textile, to use the nano cotton textile materials to help the oil devices or wearable sensor to make that. Drug delivery, huge application. So some of the professors are working with nano drug delivery. Now I'll tell you something, that is not my field. Next slide. So look at that, how application. What is this? Backside people. Some, you know that. Very popular picture nowadays. What's going on in the world last 2 years? COVID. So, look at the application of nanotechnology in medicine. Go ahead, next slide. This is the two slides they didn't want to give me, but they're my friends. They're working Pfizer and Moderna, both of them. In Maryland, they gave me these two slides because this is their disclosure and intellectual properties, but it's not will bother them, but they share with me. Next slide, please. Look at that. So, we gave already everybody gave vaccine, either AstraZeneca, either Moderna, either Pfizer. I gave them three vaccines. Before I came, I just gave the booster two. Moderna. So, killed somebody Pfizer. Look at that here. Role of nanotechnology in mRNA and means messenger RNA. Now, let's see that who will be one of the students. What is RNA? One of the students I want to hear from you. What is the abbreviation of RNA? Can you speak loudly? Don't be shy. Ribonucleic? Yes, nucleic acids, okay. So ribonucleic nucleic acids, so RNA, very important part. So here, the COVID-19, what is that? I'm just reading this, this is very important. Two mRNA-based vaccine, that is one from Pfizer, one from Moderna. What they did? They have a code number, because they use code. So Pfizer used, and BioNTech used BNT16, whatever code, and Moderna used mRNA 1273. Okay? Are nanoparticle based? Okay, what is that? Nanotechnology has played a significant role in the success of these vaccines, these two vaccines. Okay? Now, what did it? Nanoparticles aid helping in improving sterility by protecting the encapsulated, okay, mRNA. So mRNA is protein. It is protected by the layer they use, that is we call LNP, I'm coming, protecting the encapsulated mRNA from ribonucleases and facilitate delivery. Okay, remember, delivery of intact mRNA to the target site, means cell site. Okay, I'm coming more details. The overwhelming success of these two mRNA based, they are claiming 95% efficacy. They are claiming phase 3 trial. Believe me, we were surprised as all the scientists all over the world and people that it took maximum 15 to 20 years to establish a vaccine. But these guys so lucky that within within 2 years. So they succeeded a trial three. Trial three, can we attribute to the unique nano carrier? Now the nano carrier, what is nano carrier? This is the nano carrier. Lipid nanoparticles now. They didn't tell me the any content of this one. What metal they used, what kind of they used now. This is their completely disclosure of that. They just tell common name, nano, liquid nanoparticle. Okay? So this is the nano carrier. So what is that? So it is an encapsulated nano carrier. You inject it to go as a vehicle carrier to the target cell. Is it clear, everybody? Let me clear about that. Have you heard the nanobot, student? Nanobot. What is that? Nano robot. So they put nanobot. Okay, now this is the trial is going on now. Nano clinic in Ohio. Doctors in the hospital, they just injected, okay, nano robot. They take the drug. So robot is going on your body all the way, whatever your bad cell, like cancer cell, go there and then deliver the drug, kill the bad cell. That is the nano robot. And go there and then come back and return to the that nano robot. So that's their purpose. So that's what they call nano robot. It's a very small nano robot. So one thing. This is a nano carrier to go to the storage cell. So that's a very, very good discovery that this guy used this mRNA, that LNP conjugated, and then they made that and then they used as a carrier. Please next slide. Now see that the general structure LNP, lipid nanoparticle they call, lipid nanoparticle, okay? The protein, showing the major components and the unique mRNA cargo, both of them, here, look at that, delivery vehicle, lipid nanoparticle, so they use for as a mod RNA and S protein to, as a delivery to the target cell to make in your body that we are taking that, that vaccine to make the, what, antigen in your body, that's why you are protected. But still now, some people have, we found that they are still getting virus attack. But hopefully, but you know, research is going on and going on. But it's much better than before, even the different variant is coming. But Pfizer CEO, he just announced recently, he told that this virus maybe will come as a normal virus. And eventually we have to take every 6 month, 1 year vaccine. Okay, so again, the application, nanoparticle is in this medicine. Okay, next slide. Now, what we are doing in the lab? We are not working in this thing. We are working something different, drug delivery, surface to volume, to protect the degradation, breakdown, and also some drug delivery pharmacokinetics. Next, please. So what we're doing, William came as a postdoc to in my lab 7 years ago. So all of his PhD about gold nanoparticles. Look at that, X-ray CT, when you do that, your X-ray for anything, they do the X-ray CT, computer tomography they call. So normally this, so you cannot see those soft tissues clearly. When you do that, electron dense, okay? But when you use iodine, then you can see some, you see? But when you gold itself is a contrast agent. When you mix up gold nanoparticles, again, that is William did in his PhD and postdoc work. Look at that, more clear, it says that mouse, it's in mouse. Legs in vivo, before injection 2 minutes and after 2 minutes, it says that vein tumor and increased vascularity, arrow points 100 nanometer diameter. We can show that. So when you use this contrast agent gold, you can see very clear. So difference between normal extrinsicity and gold induces extrinsicity is much different. So then doctor can see much better image, and then we can treat more better treatment. Next, please. Next, what he did here in my lab. So this is in gold nanoparticles. So he used a linker, thiolic acid. Some chemistry is coming here. And then he conjugated, bind with spacer, tetraethylene glycol, or polyethylene glycol, tetra-TEG or PEG. Why we are doing that? To increase. If he use that, solubility will be very good. Otherwise, it's very difficult to solubilize. So we use that as the spacer, and then we have very clear imaging. We take MRI or X-ray or whatever. Huh? We do that. We do that. But question is, we are using some nanoprobe interaction with ACE. What is ACE? Next slide. ACE is go next slide. I just want to show you. Don't know where it is. Go ahead. Anyway, next slide. Yes. ACE means angiotensin converting enzyme. This is a one kind of receptor or drug what helps like to help the heart failure or blood pressure to reduce. So this is they use ACE. Go ahead, back. William used this ACE to bind with. Go ahead. And then make a nice, next. So now he did some synthesis, because when you publish the work, you have to do the synthesis, you have to characterize, you have to discuss, results and discussion, and then you have to conclude. So we did histogram, that TM, it's around 10 nanometer size spherical. And that, like you see that around 10 nanometer mean. So we did histogram average. This is a, we call it histogram, means average of size of these gold nanoparticles. So William Gunn, so that postdoc, he is a research academic now. He published his essay journal, Langmuir. So, and then this is the synthesis part, gold chloride with citrate and then some chemistry. You use reflexing and then citrate GMP. What for? To do the MRI, one part for this part, it's a big molecule. Then ICG indocyanine green. This is another dye we used for to make another imaging. We use lisinopril, another contrast agent for this third part. So we have made a multi-modal probe for MRI, ICG, and lisinopril. Next slide. And he published this one. What he did before injection, you see that in the mice, that gold nanoparticles, that part, when he used GNPTA that he made, lisinopril, then now you can see very, very clearly everything. Very clear compared to this image. Now, this is mice, but we're not doing human because, you know, human is not allowed, but so it's in the heart. You see that that's the ACE with this GNP, it will go. So mice is related to very human trial, as you know. So this is the way we can do that. Next, please. Now this is the very important thing, his discovery, his invention. That this 3D image intensity projection, you see that. This is a rat or mice imaging. Of the mouse, after 10 injection of GMP, when you put that gold nanoparticles, that TA, lisinopril, that complex molecule, when you put that, what happened? That lisinopril coated GMPs bind to that ACE, and then you take that in vivo, not in vitro, in vivo to show the X-ray. This is the MRI, you can do X-ray or MRI, see, when, you know, the magnetic. Imaging, magnetic, what is R? Resonance imaging. So he took it and optical contrast, he got it. And then this little portion, you see, the particular cell, this is a disease mice cell. So he injected this probe, and then he saw that the targeting cell is uropod. When he took the imaging, and then uropod, this shows that that's the cancer cell. And it's very clear that accumulation of gold correlates to the density of the targeted cell. So it's very clear, you can see that uropod is the bad cell that in the mice, then doctor or scientist can clarify, please. Next. This is gold. Then I told, okay, let's work on silver nanoparticles. So we started this thing, next slide. Next, please. So we made that gold, silver nanoparticles, took that absorption, different ratio. Next, please. Okay, so this is some high school student, undergrad did. So this is the stuff you need to make the synthesis. Go ahead. Next slide. So again, we confirmed several times the wavelength spectroscopy, and this is again DLS measurement, around size 18 nanometer. Go ahead, please. Now, antibacterial experiments. Some at the university, I know that Jainovor, SAST, even the university, some group, they are working with this one. A lot of publications they have. So we try to do that, some undergrad student, and incubated different concentration and what in E. coli. Go ahead, next bacteria. So that they found that after this concentration, no bacteria is gone. That means antibacterial. So still project is going on because we have to do a lot of data to collect it. This I want to show that silver nitrate also inhibit the growth of bacteria. That means antibacterial effect that you can see here. Okay, next please. So this gold or LNP or silver, I can tell you other also help to medicine, to antibacterial effect, different imaging contrast to see, and also some liquid nanoparticles to they are using to make vaccine. Now the very important part, another second part, we are using the efficient energy sector. Go ahead. So you know that world is now a lot of problems going on. Climate is changing. So we need renewable energy. Even burn fossil like coal, gas, and oil, still dominating, but what we are getting? Every day, every country, we are burning this gas, oil, gasoline, and coal. Another very culprit of we are burning in the industry. And what happened? All this environmental hazardous sulfur dioxide, carbon dioxide, even carbon monoxide, nitrous oxide, all this warm dump in the atmosphere. So what happened? It goes to the atmosphere. So sulfur dioxide reacts with another oxygen, because oxygen is there, so make the sulfur trioxide. When rain comes, rain is water, react with sulfur trioxide, makes what? Who can tell you? Makes what? Acid, sulfuric acid. So it's come as an acid rain. Basically, acid rain, and that's dangerous. A lot of people are suffering. China is suffering. There are a lot of people are suffering, agriculture suffering, because they have lots of pollution. A lot of sculpture is changing the color because of acid rain. Even though it's not dangerous, but it's acidic. So, one of the things is the carbon dioxide. We can capture the carbon dioxide even though the people are working. So carbon dioxide goes to the atmosphere. What happened? Ozone layer depleted, huh? Because of carbon dioxide.
Ozone layer depletion layer, ozone layer depleted and then makes the hole. And then sunlight, because of protect is gone, and then hole created. And then all the sunlight comes directly to the earth, surface of the earth. And whatever, every year we can see 1 to 2 degrees Celsius. What? Increasing the temperature. What happened? Because of global warming. Isn't it? What is global warming? So global warming is sea level increasing. Arctic, Alaska, all these are melting. So one time, Maldives or the area of our coastal area will be no more. I'm pretty sure. I was a lecturer at Hopkins when the professor was talking about Bangladesh, particularly Maldives. When can they not be exist because of increasing of the what? Sea level. So this is really dangerous. This will be real. Maybe we are not seeing now the effect now, but it's happening. It's happening now. So things are going on. So you have to be very careful. Next please. So we need a energy, this energy. All wind energy, hydro, tidal is going on. Germany is very good at solar energy. Australia, America, all the countries, Japan, there is very good in solar now. Wind is so much increasing rapidly. But solar is promising. So that's why I'm interested to work on that. Okay, go ahead. So we started to make our center when we had just started. High school student and undergraduate student to make simple, just from the glass to make a anode and cathode, to make a sandwich slide, to make a solar slide. I can show you now. They call Dyson's a solar cell or photovoltaic cell. Next slide, please. So what happened here, the Sunil that I told you, he's working as a postdoc, he simulated this design by software. Okay? So this is, we published in this journal also, Scientific Report of Nature. So what happened here, this is very simple data. So you have a sister dye, is visible light. So one slide, they call indium tin oxide. This is a conductive side. So you put the titanium dioxide again, titanium dioxide is a nanomatrix, isn't it? CO2. So it's a white paste. We put it a layer, depends on thickness. The more thickness is better. And then makes it some hole to absorb the dye. Okay, so you make the anode part on slide. Can you go back? Go, please. So this is the I2 glass. So we coat it, we paste it with the TiO2. Okay? And then spin coat it. Then this is your anode part. Then cathode part is just carbon paste we used. And this is the anode part because this is this part, same part. Now we use pomegranate. This is 2017 we published Scientific Report. It took us a couple of years to publish in this journal because six times they rejected. Okay, in that time, Swedish scientist, he was working with this pomegranate, darling Jita Makai. Done. Pomegranate, he was working in Nature, so he published in Nature Medicine. It's a very, very famous journal, Nature Medicine. So what he did, in same time, 2017, Swedish scientist. Actually, I had a video, but now it's because of time I cannot show. So he, that pomegranate juice, we take it as an antioxidant, but he did it in mice. Okay, now question is, if some enzyme, luckily that mice or human being had that, so he got some mice of that kind of enzyme, without enzyme and without enzyme, he saw that those rats or whatever, the aging, like they did 1 year, 2 years, 3 year work, or 3 months, they are not aging. They call anti-aging, remember? So they found that without that pomegranate with enzyme, they found that it anti-aging effect is going on. That means it's a very good thing that you'll be, the minds or people will be younger. That is, you want to studies that, and he did that, and he published in Nature Medicine, you know that. So luckily in that time we published this one. Well, then we added, we talked with them there, that pomegranate is one of the very good electrolyte. It's created a lot of energy. That is found here. So, go back. So mechanism is, go back. Yes. So mechanism is what? When you put that dye in the anode part and put the solar energy, okay, now the molecule is excited because of light, and then it goes to the excited state. Ground state to excited state, S star. I put it S star. So here, S0 to S star, the electron goes, okay? And then one electron jumping, yeah? In the injection of electron conduction band of TiO2. And from there, electron is go to the devices like computer or cell phone or whatever, electron flow is going on. So what is electricity? Electricity is flow of electron. So that is going on circulating. But when you put these two as a sandwich, you have to put some to help as an electrolyte. In this case, we use iron. But iron is a not good electrolyte. People are already copying that part. So we are using now solid gel type electrolyte. It's much stable and it gives more efficiency. So when we use iron, it's gradually, when you get the 2%, 3% efficiency, it gradually 6 months later it will be 1%, even 0.5%. So, very interesting thing is that electrolyte is a very important role to choose it. So, what happened? To get the lower efficiency that we are getting here, reason is stability, leaking issue, and also combination occur. That's the problem. If combination back electrolyte occur, then how can you flow of electron, it goes to the again ground state. That's the problem. That's why we are not getting the high. But now people are going to perovskite solar cell, another solar cell, to get better efficiency because it's not dissensitive solar cell. Okay, that part I will not talk with you. So this is we published in that. Go ahead. Okay, so we made that, we simulated this. Go ahead. Now we characterize this. We see that this is our first time we showed. And they're what? The viewers are very happy when we showed that. Look at that 2 to 3 nanometer that dye, that pigmentation from pomegranate. Because there are different types of, even we put that, what kind of dye for pomegranate, that 2 to 3 nanometer in 40 to 50 nanometer TI is sitting down. Very clearly. Then we show the crystal structure and we show the SAD also there. There are four different types of, we are showing, when you zoom it, you can see the SAD pattern also. Go ahead. Next we did the surface FESM. We did the EDS, we show that the components are fine. TI is there, oxygen is there, carbon is there, and we do the cross-section also. To show that, make sure that there is a glass, there is ITO, there is a TiO2, all the layers we show there. And thickness also as well. Okay, after that, we submit a go next slide please. Then we did again AFM, atomic force microscopy, to show that very clearly 3D of all this TiO2 morphology, surface morphology. Go ahead. And then after this characterization, the main goal is to show the efficiency, isn't it? So this is, we show that all this blue-green, black-green, all this berry family, we show that pomegranate is the highest percentage, more than 2% show, and this is the highest percent we show that DSC, and we did also impedance, that resistance measurement as well, zeta potential, with including current voltage, showed that, and then after that, go ahead, we published this this work in Nature Scientific Report, they accepted. And after that, I told him, why not work with the graduate undergraduate student to make gold, to use the gold and the silver see that you can make the DSC. Then we published this another health figure, very good journal. It's the same mechanism as I showed you. Go ahead. Crystallization of gold. Go ahead. With Ti2. Current voltage measurement. Look at that. 1.77 only for dye, ruthenium. When you put gold nanoparticles, you get double efficiency. That means it's a very nice plasmonic effect is going on with the gold nanoparticles. Next. So, we did the impedance as well, and then we published in that journal, LCB journal. Go ahead. Next one is the silver. Okay? Again, we did the silver, EDS, absorption, DLS, synthesis, all this part. Go ahead. Take the TM, FTIR, Raman, all this. Because the more you do the characterization, it's a proof for your too easy to publish work. Go ahead. Then current voltage again, look at that without, with all of these three together, if you use that higher efficiency compared to normal one, okay? Go ahead. Again, impedance, same methodology we use, and we publish this work. Go ahead, next. And the example. Now the, another work we did after gold and silver, I told, okay, let's work on another one. Series of work, carbon dot. Ark, super king. IIT professor Dr. Mumin Sheikh, they are our collaborator. His PhD student from IIT Indore. He made this synthesis from super king. So what he did, he burned it, made charcoal, made the carbon, and then refined it, and then he got that carbon dot. It's very process. So he did it with sodium citrate, urea. We made the C dot, all this treatment, and then we used in to use in DSC. Go ahead, next slide. Okay, so synthesis part we did, next one. We did the spectroscopy, fine, C dot, and with C dot with N719. Remember, N719 is a dye, you have to, we bought it from the commercial. Go ahead. Then we did the fluorescence emission. Go ahead, different wavelength you can see. We did the lifetime. So, lifetime, when you put the lifetime with the without dye and with dye, it increases the lifetime. Go ahead. We did the dynamic light scattering measurement, 7.5 nanometer. Go ahead, next please. We did the TM for carbon dot, and then we saw that 6 nanometer. DLS we got 7. DLS is roughly slightly. For TM you can get the correct diameter. So it's very similar. That was 7 or 8 nanometers, this is 6 nanometers roughly. So we did very nice histogram here. So this is all this the carbon dot you can see in the TR, big chunk TR. Go ahead, next. Then we do the EDS. Carbon is there because mostly carbon. Sugarcane, yeah? Oxygen, yeah. Okay, go ahead. Then we did FTIR and which band, which wedge band, carbon double bond, carbon bond. All of this we did that, and of course put in the paper, our paper. Go ahead. And then we gave the current voltage data. Go ahead. And then we publish this. This is a around 6 to 7 impact factor. So Sharma and Mubin is a team leader, and our group, all this group, look at that. One of the Banashi group also, he did some work. Raman is King Abdulaziz University. Saudi Arabia, Bangladesh. There is another name is Keniso University. First, Nijam. Ken, Farin, William. But we, they are all our students, so we did this work. Go ahead. And so, this is the part of energy. And I can tell you maybe another 20, 15 to 20 project for to publish this, this different type of energy related source of maybe. But few of them we did that, that's why I show. This is the last one. Okay. application of nanotechnology in the environment. This is very important, as I told you. Okay, go ahead. So nanofiltration. This is a, as I told you, that some slides I will show you, but this is just we submitted a patent. So this is a disclosure and very intellectual properties. So what we did that nanofiltration. Look at that, some of the stuff in our water, even we don't know that nanoparticles are there. So we are drinking. Look, this water. So when you put in the car, you park the car, the sunlight comes, car gets heat. That, do you know that this is approved? Do you know that from that water plastic, microplastic is releasing in the water and we are drinking. In our body is going. This is true. This is the published. Now we are working on nanoplastic. So this kind of things to clarify, to get out this kind of toxic element, that's why we started this project, okay? So what we did, the University of Maryland professor, Abraham Siddiq, Dr. Shamsuddin, he discovered a cancer prevention, not cure, prevention medicine. He called IP6. Inositol hexaphosphate. You can get it, Google it, you can get it. It's by his picture, it's a patented, and people are buying from the internet. It's a natural cancer prevention medication for making from rice hull. Rice hull. Go ahead. So, how he made it? Sodium IPC6, citric acid. So we take that rice hull stuff and put it sodium hydroxide, so sodium, and then citric acid, and we make IP6 hexacitrate. So that IP6 hexacitrate, when you bind with cellulose, go ahead. Next please. Cellulose, IP6 citrate modified cellulose, like glucose, cellulose means glucose. When you modify, then we see that when we did the some experiment, go ahead, next please. We did the FTIR, go ahead. And we did some experiment with atomic absorption spectroscopy and cyclic bolometry. So we did some standard calibration and then we found some results, go ahead. Go ahead. So look at that, that is I want to show, even though it's patented. So we found that 98% we removed this kind of what? Metal ion, cadmium or lead or chromium with IPCC cell, with when you bind it, it chelated, it killing all this or chelated, whatever. This, and then we found that 99% of this metal chelated. This is one of the very innovative experiments we did until now in our lab, and I hope we will get a patent for that, then after that we'll publish it. Go ahead please. And then this one is removal, but this one is, we already published here, Journal of Nanomedical, to detect in the water we have lead or chromium or whatever, cadmium, how did you know that kind of test level, ppm or parts per million or ppb level, how do you know that we have lead is there, okay? So to detect that lead, what we do, we use the gold nanoparticles. And one of the acid, they call lipoic acid, we functionalized it, okay? Yes, I have some few minutes, so I'll try to finish. So we are detecting, you see that color is changing to detect that. That means when color change, that lead concentration is more there. That means lead is there. So we can detect that element is there. Okay, next. We did some experiment, all of this. Make sure that we have to be careful if not to be aggregate. Very negligible aggregation, we saw that. Very negligible. Look at the picture here and this. This is more closing, aggregate. So if it is aggregate, that's different. That means your data is nothing, now fresh. So we have to be very careful. Next. what is the journal? We use that iron geovalent nanoparticle to make in the algae. That algae, to interact with algae, and then we found that that gold nanoparticle is useful to make biofuel. So this is our collaboration with one of our another group, Indian group, Dr. Sitter. So we published the ACS Omega. Next please. So we showed the beautiful, look at the control algae and with iron. Next slide. If you go more close, then you can see very images of iron here. Next please. So I'm finishing the 5 minutes, as I said. So interdisciplinary research. Now question is, as I told you that, you have a chemistry, you have a physics, you have a triple E, you have a mechanical engineering. So nano work is actually interdisciplinary. So what I did, I brought the genome, is an environmentalist, I brought the solid, organic, synthetic, I brought the Nesbitt, computational simulation work, I brought the Savage, inorganic faculty, and myself, chemistry and nanotechnology. So all together, we work together as a team. Okay, and I brought that these people, analysts for nursing or medicine, even business, to bring the money, to as a team. This is in a house, I'm talking about company state. Interdisciplinary. That is you guys need to make it here. Okay, next please. So this is my some collaboration in out of state. This is some Saudi Arabia. This is some from Bangladesh. First, ongoing last 2 years, Jamal University, Chiang University, Kuwait, Kuwait University. This is IIT India, Malaysia. This kind of things going on. I can have a lot. I'm just focusing some of them. Go to next please. So, that part I want to show you. So, this is a 22 publication right now, 21, it's last year. This is January. Publication is all this collaboration is going on with outside of the country or inside the country. All these journals are very highly impact and very peer reviewed journal. We published all of them. Go to the next slide. To see that all the 2021, everything, I'm not putting 2020 or 2019, all 21. All this, such a small way, we have very few people are working. The possible is happening because of collaboration. Go ahead, next, 21. So, this is, I'm talking about next, please. So, these three things that 22 publication, 22, another 10 publication on the way. 10 is already working on that, is going on. All these things are coming because of collaboration, teamwork, interdisciplinary because of this. If I do alone work, maybe I can publish even 5 or 2 or 3. So then I did some group work here. This is a, I can tell you, I'm very lucky. Macro to nano spectroscopy 2007, 15 maybe. This is 17. So this is one of the key that 150,000 citations right now. So we have this, and this is 50,000 citations going on. Very, very popular topics for macro to nano spectroscopy. So we have we are very lucky to publish from our center. Go ahead. So this is, we are hosting some conferences. He's a Japanese professor, very renowned. She's our president, but not now. He's a famous guy, keynote speaker. We sometimes we invited some professor. Go ahead. This is the KISS program, STEM. Every year, high school student, middle school student come, and we have a grant for that. Go ahead. We have a founding agent is NSF. So we have a right now $1.5 million, but you know money is wrong always. Just hopefully March or April I can hear for this $500,000. Hopefully I will get it. But 3 times I applied but rejected. This is my 3rd time. But I will apply until I get it. I don't know. So this is my 4th time. Go ahead. So this is our group. See, organic, synthetic, solely. So Jim is here somewhere. It's a Korean guy. He's our all the team. He's very expert. He's the only one, all the time shooting, he's working. William, he's my main guy. Hopefully, he will fill up my position next. and all these students, all are undergraduate students. Mm. Go ahead next. These are undergrad. This is a two PhD student from another university. I'm the co-advisor. He just finished Samsung. Tony is working for two projects. They are undergraduate. They'll go to the PhD program, four of them. Go ahead. Now I'm finishing. I think I make your time. So I'll take some question and answer from you. If you have any question, student, you can also ask me any kind of research or higher education type work, please. But my goal is here to come here to talk to another piece, VC and other professor, how we can establish a center just we saw the fruit already in AIB. 24 January there will be an international conference that I always do. So they have a center right now in house. They got some money, but I did it in 2 years ago to influence them. VC for that university, please make it. And now they have center. And I'm sure we'll have one. Any question?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay, thank you so much for your nice presentation. I have two queries. The first one is, I have a long experience of preparing colloidal manganese dioxide. Mm-hmm. That is manganese dioxide nanoparticles in colloid form and solid nanoparticles. So do you think that it can be used for the replacement of gold nanoparticle?
I am not sure, but because this is a colloidal particles, it's a big one. Make sure you have to bring it in a nano level. I'm not sure it's a totally different work what you're doing. But manganese as itself, like iron, gold, silver, or other metal, can be possible to bring in to make a nanoparticles. But colloidal,
okay, thank you so much. Another question is, you showed some removal performance using dye cell. So is it better than adsorption process? Or what was the process you mentioned here?
So you were talking about that filtration?
Yeah.
So you say adsorption, of course, because we are using resin. And different concentration, we saw that lead, cadmium is all 20 ppm started, 19.5% almost we can remove there. Yes, it's the adsorption process.
Okay, thank you so much.
Very good question. I want to hear from some question from students.